Okay, here's another League of Legends free play coming your way, this time with Xin Zhao in the jungle. So, if you take a look at the two team comps while you wait for everyone to trickle out, hopefully you can see the obvious problem. Enemy team has Gangplank top, Kha'Zix jungle, Ziggs mid, Twitch AD carry, Brand support with GP, Kha'Zix, and Twitch being all pre-made. In case you're wondering, other than Twitch who's running Warlord's Bloodlust, they're all running Thunderlords. I think even Brand is. For our team, we have Teemo top, Xin Zhao jungle, which is me, we have Ori mid, Yi AD carry, who picked this because our... I want to say it's the Teemo who banned out who he wanted to play, so he decided to go Yi. And yeah, you can kind of imagine how this bot line's gonna go. And then we have Lux support. As for my team, Yi and I are running Fervor of Battle, everyone else is running Thunderlords. So this really reminds me of when these keystones first input, because you got to see everyone take Thunderlords, pretty much. But otherwise, in case you're wondering, runes and masteries I will show at the end of this game, along with the various graphs. But I start with Machete because Xin is all about the single target clear. With his attack speed, this 25 adds up really, really fast. Now, I would not say he takes as fast as Udyr, Shyvana, and a couple others, but he's like the next tier down. So you can see Yi is helping, Lux isn't. And I should put down a challenge for you guys. Out of all five people on my team, who do you think is going to do the least amount of damage? You'll find out at the end. But one other thing I can mention is, if you want to know why this is a replay instead of me just showing the live game, the game eventually did devolve down to me just cursing at my teammates. It's kind of sad that it really got to that point, but when you actually see the damage graphs, you'll understand everything, I think. So right here, you need your E to actually clear all the small stuff pretty quickly. Overall, I'm not too concerned because I have red buff and I'm Xin, so I have a pretty safe clear. If you're not aware, his W provides him a lot of sustain. But going back to the whole teammate thing, like, the only comparable time I can think of to this one was the one Caitlyn game I have on the channel. So if you're really interested, you can go ahead and pull that one up, but this is just one of those games where the team is absolutely crap and I'm trying to do everything. The one I do have to give a shout out to is Lux. She was... I guess I can spoil it for you. She's number two for damage in the end. She's easily the most valuable member of the team, so that kind of tells you that if you know what you're doing on support, you really can have an impact. But if you're clueless, you're hopeless. That's all it comes down to. So anyway, I have all my skills up here. I'm going to go to the top lane to try to focus GP because he's pretty immobile. All things considered, with the exception of Kha'Zix, they all are immobile. And I'm going to do what I can to set back Ka. So if you look, we were both doing similar clears. He's bothering with the chicken camp, which I skipped. So I figure, you know what? I can work my way over to his jungle, see where he is, maybe catch him off guard. While Ka does thrive with isolation, the thing is, with all my free stats and everything, it's not going to be a fight he wants to take, I'll put it that way. You can see I'm at full health. I still have a charge of my potion. He took all the consumable potions, and he's that poor. So right here I want to save Smite for the red buff in case I can't take it. Okay, I saw Kha'Zix coming around with my ward, so I just decided I'll take the golem for the 70 gold, and he can have his red buff. I mean, I took the really valuable one, and I'm kind of content with that. But I still want to make his life miserable, so I stuck around the area. I was hoping there would be a ward around here that could see me, that way he'd think I was hovering around. But since I'm not seeing him come back until just now, I wasn't entirely sure how he was for vision and everything. What's worse is you can tell that my team is pushing up. Xin is pretty reliant on ganks, and there's nothing on the field for me. One other thing I should point out, for Xin, your only CC comes... you have a slow on your E. I'll get to E in a second. You have a knockback on your ult, and then you have a knock up on your Q. So if you wanted to take Courage of the Colossus, you'd have to get the third Q strike. Otherwise, your ult is the only other way to proc it. One other thing I should point out about the ult before we continue is that it deals a percentage HP damage that's not too important since there's no tank on the enemy team, but the big thing is, if you actually look at it, it gives you free armor and MR for 6 seconds based on the number of enemies hit. This will come in handy for a play later on in the game. But anyway, I managed to get the red buff since Teemo forced Kai out, and I figure I'll return the favor, Teemo. Let's go pay a visit to GP. So you can see he's at half health. Right there I got both of his summoners. I think I pinged that those are out. And I figure, okay, he has to recall, he has no teleport, easy lane for Teemo, I'm gonna recall too, but then he goes back in lane, if you look at the minimap. That's when I realize, okay, gotta finish him, gotta finish him off. So, right here I'm trying to see, is this warded? And the answer is no. So, he hits level 6, Teemo and I go in, and down goes GP. Now, I'm not entirely sure how he hit the 6 first, but I'm assuming that's because Teemo left lane. Since he was farming under his tower, I was wondering, could he be behind in CS? Like, did Teemo zone him so that he didn't actually get full EXP or what exactly? I'm not entirely sure, but I don't know. So anyway, if you notice, Teemo started with the Ruby Crystal, so he has no mana regen. Since he's running Thunderlords, it's possible he could have a point in meditation, but if you don't have anything to actually boost your mana pool, it's not going to be too influential. So in GP's case, now that he has the extra 250 mana from the Sheen, if he had any points in meditation, they'd be much more effective. But anyway, on this back, I go ahead and pick up my recurve bow, I get my my talisman, I get the boots. I still have to figure out how to show the gold totals, but overall, we're in a pretty good spot, and we've set Kha'Zix back somewhat. You can see he went back, he got boots and a longsword. Huh. For the side of the jungle he started on, he actually would have had a better start with the machete than the talisman. I don't know. Lots of weird stuff happens this game. But anyway, I said I was going to talk about the E. So he's a melee against 2 range characters, one of which can slow, one of which can stun. And he has a Duran Blade for lifesteal. He doesn't have the Warlord's Bloodlust for sustain, so I don't know how he planned on doing anything in that lane. So you can see he died, Lux died. Lux is going to ping that Ka used his his flash. And I figure, you know what, I'm going to teach that bug a lesson. So I already stole 2 of his buffs. I dropped a ward over here so I could see him coming. Then I go in on him. I wasn't sure if he was going to leap away, so I decided to just use my ult for the extra burst. It's going to do 100 flat damage plus some HP damage. And his team can't really follow up on that, so I can go ahead and help myself to more stuff, and he's set even further back. Now, the bad news is he did get a kill somewhere, so he managed to upgrade his longsword into a Tiamat. And with the beating he was taking in the jungle, this was kind of necessary, unfortunately for him. He realized that in order to stay relevant, he needed to start farming, and that Tiamat was needed to do so. And they did see me here. So you can see GP killed Yi. That's gonna be the story of the game, I'm afraid. Good news is the Teemo is actually kind of decent. He does not abuse the Gunblade, unfortunately, he just goes for kind of a weird build, to be honest. Had he gone for Gunblade, he actually would have been able to 1v2, which is especially devastating against Gangplank, since you can Q and negate his Q. It would help with Ka's auto-attacks too, and then he could kite them with shrooms, so I think he made a bit of a mistake in that. What's worse is the way he does go doesn't actually help. So right there they got the first dragon, which is a water dragon. I really don't care. I really have doubts that we're going to win this, so my overall goal is just try to set Ka back as far as possible, wherever I can. So he spent time trying to kill the dragon. I can go ahead and help myself to the top side of his jungle. And here I decide to make a play on Zug, so I can try to get Ori going. So in case you didn't see what happened there, I can actually rewind this a bit, and I'll slow it down. Oops. So for Ziggs, his getaway is his satchel charge. Now if I do not use my E on him, that means that he doesn't actually have the challenge on him, and thus my ult will knock him back. So I use my E on this minion to get in close. Ori moves in, he drops his satchel, I knock him out of his satchel. So Ori whiffs her shockwave, the other story of the game. I flash the brand W, and I'm going all in on Ziggs. And this is a pretty exciting chase. So, Ziggs ults, I got the brand exhaust, luckily Ori shielded me there, so I have a little bit of protection for this coming up here. So I'm running Bandit, as a result I don't get the dangerous game boost, but I do get the red buff heal and my third proc of W. So, I E to the minion to safety, and I am out of there. So right here, I think my team was actually laughing in chat. I imagine they'd probably be raging in chat, but it doesn't matter to me. So right here with my W, the lifesteal from the machete and everything, I can actually stay somewhat sustained off of this. In case you're wondering, my plan for this game is to go for Bloodrazor, then Blade of the Rune King, and from there, just go tanky. Unfortunately, since I don't have Purge of the Colossus, I don't really scale off HP, but I will build a Black Cleaver. Black Cleaver is my final item. Starting to come. So right here, Gangplank is pushed up kind of far. Unfortunately, Teemo is going back. I think he asked me to cover the lane, which I'm willing to do, it's just I'm waiting for GP to push it in. Plus, I kind of want this just to deny from Ka. I went ahead and smited that so I didn't have to take longer than I had to. You can see Teemo's teleport is down, so he does need a little help here. So Teemo, he's in the mindset that he's going to split push this game. I just noticed he has two haunting guises. So, yeah, the penetration is unique. Unfortunately, he only gets the health and AP out of that, which is not very efficient. Like, it's more comparable to say he'd be better off just having the independent Amp Tome and Ruby Crystal. And I did not think that we could win a 2v2 because I didn't really have a lot of faith in Teemo at the moment. So I was more interested in disengaging, trying to get them out so Teemo can farm up. But as for the other lanes we can check in, Yi is rushing an Essence Reaver. I should point out, now Yi can stay somewhat healthy with Meditate, you may be thinking about that. We can actually jump over to him so I can read these moves to you. Never mind, he doesn't even have the damn thing. Like, I didn't know this at the time, but this gives him 30 health per second for 4 seconds, basically 120. It does have a massive cooldown, but the health increase is based on how wounded he is. Now, he does take reduced damage, but the thing is, Brand can very easily knock him out of this with his, well, any spell followed by Q. So, Yi is playing this extremely poorly. So right here, Teemo teleported in. I go ahead and kill them. And I wasn't really keeping track of this at the time, but that is my 5th kill. So if you weren't paying attention, kill number 1 was Gangplank top. Basically right here under his tower. Kill number 2 was Kha'Zix in his jungle, very close to where Ka was. Kill 3 was Ziggs right here where this pink ward is. Then kills 4 and 5 are down here where Twitch and Brand died. So, had I been running Bounty Hunter, that would have put me at max stacks. Actually, I think I am running it, since I'm... Yeah, I am, so... You'll see the page at the end. So that's a 7.5% boost to my damage. And it's worth pointing out this was within the first 15 minutes of the game. As a result of this, the enemy is hard-pressed to duel me anywhere. More often than not, they're going to be running double-edged swords, so while they deal 5% increased damage, they're going to take an additional 2.5. The significance of this is 2.5 with 7.5 means they take an additional 10% damage from me. And then I can nerf their damage with Challenging Smite. So, 20% reduced damage. In a one-on-one fight, they do not have an answer to me. So if you're wondering how this game can go south so quickly, you're going to find out shortly. By the way, on that back, I went ahead and finished the Bloodrazor, I got Swifties, I got a Cutlass, and a Dagger for the Bloodrazor King. So right there, Gangplank ulted somewhere. Maybe the top lane. And here I'm going to kill Ziggs. So he used his satchel. I don't know the cooldown on that since I'm not really familiar with Ziggs, but I know I can kill him. So I'm waiting for him to get a little close. Trying to bait him a bit by wasting some mana and cooldowns. Also gain some health where I can, since I do have lifesteal. I flash E. Red buff is on him, so he can't run away. And that's that. So if you notice, he has tier 1 boots, and he's ranged, so he's probably going to be sitting on 330 base movement speed, I want to say. We can peek. So yeah, he's going to be around 330. Meanwhile, I have 400, even. And since there's no bot lane in the bot lane, we can go ahead and take the dragon. Earth I consider to be probably the single most valuable dragon, especially in a game like this where I could fall back into split pushing. And to spoil it a bit, the Earth Dragon is going to play a very important role for the sieges. I'm trying to remember when it is I decide to go top and help Teemo take those. In case you're wondering, Yi is not going to leave bot lane until the very, very end of the game. So, you could argue we're down a man in the first place just for him picking Yi and playing it the way he has been. But it's even worse. Now, Ori realizes she's doing poorly. She pretty much gives up any blue buff on the game. She says give it to Lux whenever it comes up later. So, yeah, Ori's just gonna be a shield bot, I'm afraid. So Gangplank just pinged his R. Realizing there's not really much I can do in a siege, I'm torn between actually trying to do something top. I realize, hey, it's getting kind of late, we can do this real easily. I have a lot of sustain just from my Cutlass, my W, my jungle item. I can pretty much tank this very safely, as you can see here. And I want to give this to Teemo because I was hoping he could be the other split pusher. We basically shove three of our guys mid, I go one lane, Teemo goes the other, and then we just push. Now, this does mean there's really no room for Yi in our team comp, but the fact is, there's no room for Yi in our team comp. If we actually had a ranged AD carry, he could build Hurricane and actually join the Ori and Lux, but yeah. We're down a man, I'm afraid. So right here is going to be the top lane siege. I believe we're going to take two towers. So I'm waiting right here for Teemo to push it up, but because of the way he built, he is really, really bad at pushing. So that's one, and they're actually starting to move top. I end up taking the Ziggs Q, but I really don't care because I'm pretty strong. The problem is, I did not know Twitch was there. Had he not been there, I think we would have been fine because Twitch is their fed one. He is the entire enemy team. And it's going to be that way for a long time. So Lux gave it a shot. Unfortunately, there's not really much to be had here. You can see her getting zoned out. So Ori shows up. I was pretty optimistic here. It's just I didn't know Ori was this weak. So in case you're wondering what she's actually up to, She plans on going Seraphs and Morellos. This gives her a lot of mana, and then the Seraphs turns that mana into actual AP. So I was thinking, okay, late game, once she has the completed Seraphs and the Morellos, she's going to have quite a bit of AP. Yeah, that's not going to happen. So right there, Yi lost to Ka. Not really much to say there. What's worse is if you realize Ka still doesn't have a completed jungle item, so it's not like he even red smited Yi, it's just he straight up beat Yi. Now, unfortunately, this tower is going to stand for a very, very long time. Due to just how bad the Ori plays this, we're technically down, I'd say, half a player with her. So right here, we did know Ka was here. I was kind of hoping he'd come in there, because if he jumped in, he's leaving in a box. There's no way out for him. So I decided, you know what, let's try to make a play on Twitch. I wasn't sure if there were any wards here. I decided to just move on in. So what Twitch does here is actually a little sneaky, but it doesn't quite work, I'm afraid. So we realized he went back. I realized he might be making his escape up the river. So Lux cuts off this path, and here I am. So she's going to throw her Q. And down he goes. So I remember Twitch was not too happy there, thinking that he almost got away. Funny thing is, had he actually, from the tri brush, went down deeper into the jungle, he would have been fine. Trying to go up here was a little risky since we didn't have any vision. But anyway, at this point you should know the drill, since Ka is kind of lacking, I decided to just pressure him a bit more. Now he is stealing CS from wherever he can get it, I think more often than not it's going to be top lane. So that allows him to stay up and level. But the thing is, I have 7 kills. In terms of gold, this more than offsets the 40 CS he has on me. Plus, a lot of the stuff I'm taking are his big things. So right here, I'm taking this because the dragon is coming up. It's going to be another earth dragon. Overall, like I said last time, this is a good thing. It's going to speed up our overall objective taking. Basically, it'll give us a little bit of a window to actually take future dragons, to take Baron, potentially, or any sort of tower siege if we can get anything going. So, they know we're here. None of them made a move, so free Earth Dragon. Next one is Cloud, which is actually decent for Xin. It helps you actually get into the fray. But like usual with Xin, there's only one way you go, which is in. If you don't kill them, you're gonna die yourself. Now, he did pop his Yomus. I didn't know he had this yet. That's how he gets out of this. And fortunately, they all pile up on me here. Didn't know she actually hit that. But you also have to remember, Teemo has the Rift Herald buff. That only works when he's solo, so if he's not actually on his own, that's not actually a thing. It's just gonna tick away. So look at all that Liandry's damage. Surely that means Teemo's gonna be number one for damage, right? Now the flip side of this is there is no tank. For the Liandry's damage to really add up, there needs to be one. For Gangplank, he has a Trinity, Ka's gonna go Black Cleaver, that's their source of additional HP, Brand has his Roa. The fact that he even got this tells you how poorly this bot lane was played. So let's see, she got about 800 gold from this, he got 600. So right here, there's nothing I can do until my team makes a move, so I figure I'll keep farming, get whatever I can, where I can. Just kind of hoping I'd be able to flank, move in from behind or something to pick off someone like Twitch. But yeah, that's not really gonna happen. So right here, I end up going down. Sadly, there isn't really much I can do when they decide to group, because my team is extremely far behind. Overall, in terms of gold, you can see we're down 3,500, which is going to go up to about 4,500 now. That's about 4,000 even. Teemo isn't pressuring anything. Ori is crap. E is crap. This is pretty much why I decided not to upload the live commentary, because I was even worse than this in-game. So right here I'm working on getting a dead man's plate so I can actually run people down, or worst come to worst, actually just run out of a fight. Unfortunately, movement speed items are kind of hard to come by in this game. Unless you want to build Yomus, Static Shiv, Trinity Force, basically what the Gangplank did in yesterday's game. And you can see it did not work out well for him. So at this stage of the game, we can look over item builds while we wait. Gangplank has Yomu's Trinity. I don't really know why people still build Yomu so much. I can see it on some junglers. It's just, in the case of Kha'Zix, his old passive, synergizes with the Duskblade so well, it's like a must-buy if you know what you're doing. So right there you can see, I'm not too concerned about the Twitch, it's just his team is leagues ahead of mine. You could argue I was caught out, yes, but the thing is, my team is literally doing nothing. Teemo is sitting over here, he's not farming, he's not doing anything, he's not taking advantage of his buff, he's not pushing, he's not farming, he gets no EXP, no gold, nothing. Ori, she tried to push this, I guess she gets some effort points for that, but even still, I don't even know where to begin. Basically, when I have games like this, I can definitely see the whole argument for Elo Hell existing. I don't know how it is I get these mid laners who really have no clue what they're doing. I can somewhat understand the AD carry, since AD carry sucks to play these days, but I just get some really weird teammates these days. What's worse is, with the Ori Lux, it should be extremely hard for the enemy to siege against us. But they're not really taking advantage of that. I think the good news is at this point Lux realized she's going to actually need to be our AP carry and she's going to start moving her build accordingly. But overall, like right here I'm planning to do a ball delivery thing. And right there you can see we actually did combo that properly. She pulled them all in for me to knock back. This gave me a surge of defensive stats. It's kind of hard to see now, but they only lasted 6 seconds. And overall with that combo we should have been much, much better off than we were, but you can see we only killed their support and they killed 3 of us. Now granted, it is our 3 least valuable members, but still, it's really, really bad. So at this point I started a surrender vote because I just gave up. I had no faith in them whatsoever. The Ori is 1-4, Yi is 3-9, Teemo, he has a Gnasher's Tooth, which boosts his dueling, which would be something if he were dueling. But you can see with the way he's been playing the game so far, that does not do a damn thing for him. Anyway, we lose our inhibitor tower. Luckily, we do defend the inhibitor. Right here, I'm making a beeline straight for the dragon, because Gangplank's saying, "You ran past Twitch, go back and get him, go back and get him." I don't give a damn. I want this cloud dragon so that I can actually move around better. You can see I have 451 movement speed with the fully charged, what's it called? Dead Man's Plate. And sadly, right here, since my flash is down and Twitch is up, he is going to kill me, but this is my dragon. Now, unfortunately, my Blade of the Rune King isn't actually up just yet. It came up right around now, so I couldn't even use that to get him. So I ping that he flashed, and I'm actually content with this because this helps us significantly. The other thing worth pointing out is that was the final elemental. So if we can get the Elder Dragon, that means we will move a little bit more quickly. And this would really help our split push if we had one, but can't really stress enough how bad this team was. I'm kind of wondering at this point if I should just try to face tank the tower. It's down to, that's 1080 approximately. But unfortunately, with its full armor and everything, it's not possible. But right here you can see how much Teemo has fallen off. Gangplank has the CS and the kill lead on him, and remember, he does have the Rift Herald buff. He's going to have that for about 7 more minutes. So at this point I'm starting to max the W, which is pretty important. I'm going for a Spirit Visage because I'm all about healing right now. This is going to be really, really bad for the enemy team when we actually have a fight. It's going to be right around, right here where this blast cone is. You'll see how much it actually takes for them to kill me when we fight there. Basically, the way it's going to work is I will get some healing from the Spirit Visage, just because it's a healing item. I have Lifesteal from Blade of the Rune King, and I'll be getting additional life back from the Battlecry passive. So this is basically an additional 60 health every third hit. When you add in the Spirit Visage, it actually boosts it to around 70. And right here, as soon as I see Kai, I jump on him because I know I'm stronger than him. In case you're wondering why I ulted there, was for the defensive stats. I figured Ziggs was going to be laying down a lot more harass than he actually was, it's just he didn't. He does have 30% CDR in his build right here, so he should have been able to spam to his heart's content. And yes, I did see that blue ward, it's just I didn't care. Right here I'm kind of hoping I can block whoever's coming up to take the top lane CS, but Teemo takes so damn long to push. Like, if his build order, none of it really makes sense. But here we're going to have our next fight. So I end up taking the Ziggs Q. It's not really a big deal because I do have a little bit of MR plus a lot of healing. The Brand stuff is a little bit worse because he does do percent HP damage. So right here I decide to make my move. I'm after Twitch because, like I said earlier, he is the dangerous one. He is the enemy team. So Brand stuns me, but it doesn't matter because I can just jump on Twitch. I'm hitting this for lifesteal. And I actually want the guys up top. So Gangplank, I smite him so I can see him in the brush. He dies to the combined red buff challenging smite. Brand and Ziggs are the only two left. And I thought they could see me. I was actually operating here on the information that they had a ward by the red buff. Apparently they didn't. So I go ahead and help myself to Brand. Ziggs is kind of in a bad spot, but there's no follow-up possible here. Now you'll notice Ori is full health, full mana, and everything, but like I said, she never amounts to anything. So right here is when I actually take an attempt at hitting the tower a couple times because I do have the red buff. You can see there's nothing to it. Now I could have used the Q for a little bit of extra damage, but it's not really a big deal. And I don't really care about taking damage from Ziggs here because I can outrun him. Bad part is that Mega Inferno Bomb has like a 1 minute cooldown, I think. Yep, 1 minute right now. So he just went back, he got his death cap, I'm going back and getting my visage. And the item I want next is the Black Cleaver. For CDR purposes, that way I can use my E more often to actually get into the fights. You'll see that's at about an 11 second cooldown right now, where I only have the 10% CDR from the visage. Normally it's a 12 second cooldown. So if I can get the 20% from the Cleaver, that will boost me up to... let's see, it's 10.8 now, it's going to lose 2.4, so it'll be 8.4 seconds for every jump. Now if I have blue buff, I'll actually have 40% CDR, and then it'll be down to 8 seconds, or 7-something, I think. But anyway, the Elder is coming up. We did get Ziggs, we got Twitch. This should be pretty good for us, but unfortunately, in the back of my mind, I knew they were going to blow it somehow. So, let's move over to Master Yi. Gangplank does have a Banshee Veil, but you can see that one Q chunked him. I couldn't believe how much damage he took off of that. So I was planning on the two of us going on Gangplank because Yi could pop Highlander and just stick to him, but... the thing is, he's fragile as glass. Unfortunately, I have no idea what Teemo, Ori, or Yi were thinking most of this game, because there's a little bit of an argument to be made they weren't thinking at all. So he does manage a dual GP here. He did pop Highlander to do so, but the important thing is that does set us up to go ahead and take the Elder Dragon. So I'm cool with taking this because I have everything in my favor. Lifesteal from both the Bork, the jungle item, healing from the Visage, my W. This is pretty much free, and I probably actually could solo it, it's just Teemo is here to speed up the whole process. So Yi and Lux go down, Gangplank already died, Bran goes down, so in the end that was kind of a 2-for-2. And then we have the Elder Dragon on three of us. I was looking at the minimap because I didn't know if Teemo was going to get caught there. You can see he went for the Fromel. This is decent in lane, but at this point it's just too little too late. You can see he's rushing a Zerat portal. There's no synergy in this build. He's literally all over the place. No mana regen, no CDR. Well, he has CDR from the Gnasher Tooth. But, yeah. Not a good Teemo build. So right here I'm taking this just in case they want to try to do Baron. And so at this point it should be kind of obvious, but I'm willing to 1v1 anyone. I literally fear no man. Unfortunately, I was hoping Teemo would be up a little bit further, but he wasn't. If he actually had Ravidon's death... oh god. If he had, not Ravidon's, Runon's Hurricane, he'd be able to move a little bit faster, he'd be able to push better. Like I said, he's just all over the place this game. So Yi is back to bot lane. I'm still convinced at this point that it's completely a losing game. Like, Lux is the only one I can really rely on. She's up to just under 500 AP. She has Morellos and Rabadons. Like I said, she transitions into our AP carry. So she has 400 right there. Ori has less AP than the support. Yep. What's worse is she does have the Seraphs now, so you can see she gets plus 78 ability power from the, well, just all the mana items she has. She went for Luden's Echo, which helps her move, but it's not really that good of a buy, I'd say, at this point. She would have been much better off going for an actual death cap, so she had more AP. She could have went for a Void Staff for penetration purposes. There were a lot of better items she could have got than this. Anyway, I'm up, I'm bot lane. Here I'm just trying to farm up so I can get my items. I have the Phage for movement speed. Somehow Ori killed Brand. And I do not really want to rewind to find out how. So at this point I'm hoping that Yi and I can actually catch someone. They go ahead and take that. I don't really care. The important thing there is they revealed that there were three of them there, and I figured Twitch was probably somewhere nearby because his two pre-made buddies were. And I can't trust Yi to ride shotgun on anything I do. So, good news, we're 40 minutes in. Yi has finally left bot lane. So by throwing everything we have, we are able to kill Twitch, we kill Ziggs. I was thinking Yi for Ziggs is an amazing trade. Maybe we can actually get something done somewhere. Which brings us to top lane. So Teemo has his Zerat set up. If GP knew what he was really doing, he could kill these pretty easily. Like, those should not actually be hitting the tower. There he goes. And they actually do give him Silver Serpents. So right here is the end of Teemo's split push. Can we actually see how many serpents he has? Damn. I was kind of hoping we could at least see what upgrades he had also. Actually, yeah, we can. Let's jump over to GP for a second. Maybe he actually does have all three. He's kind of fed. Yep, that just makes things all the worse for us. So the good news is, most of us are level 18 now. The only ones who aren't are the supports. Our Lux is 17, their Brand is 15. He does not have his rank 3 ult just yet. So we can go ahead and take that to give us vision around the Baron. And we're just trying to death brush real quick. So right there, if you didn't see the plus 10 gold, GP is running Bandit like I am. Kinda makes sense when you remember he is running Thunderlords. Now, I thought their ward was further in, but oh well. Got some mana out of Ziggs. His spells are actually pretty pricey. If you didn't see his Q right there, it costs 70 mana. He does get... he has a little bit from his Morello and Lich Bane. Here's the big fight. Here you get to see my ult in full effect. So right there, 4-man ult. Twitch down. GP Guardian Angel pop. So Yi arrived a little late, but had the team done literally anything, we could have actually won that much, much better. So I'm actually going to pull up my stats here so you can read it. So every guy I hit gave me 25 armor and MR. So when I hit 4 of them, that was basically 100 armor and MR added onto my stats. I had 262 armor, 235. So during those 6 seconds, or is it 7? 6. They really couldn't hurt me. That's one of the reasons why I was able to stick in there the way I could. The other thing that was working in my favor was all this lifesteal and healing I have. So this is 90 points of healing. When you factor in the Spirit Visage, that puts it about 110. Plus my lifesteal from the Bork, healing from just the Visage itself. It's kind of difficult for them to actually hurt me if I can get ults off like that. Problem is, like I said, weak teammates. So I think right here I was waiting for the elixir. So this gives me even more lifesteal. So the next time I go in there like that, it's going to be that much harder to kill me because I have just ridiculous healing. So right now I am full build. I have the completed cleaver. You can see this is down to an 8.4 second cooldown. This is 70. So every Q does additional 350 damage. And that's not even accounting the bonus crit damage here. Yeah, I can really duel anyone here. Sad part is, since we don't have a true AD carry, my dueling potential is not as significant. So, Ori whiffed her ult. Again. And right here I'm going to kill the bug. Here I have to do basically what I did earlier with the satchel charge. So I need to knock him down, take him down, and now I need to get in front of him so I can use my crescent sweep and knock him out of his leap. Like that. And that's game over. So Yi is dueling Twitch in the bot lane. We have the numbers advantage here, and we actually took out Ka, one of their good guys, without losing anyone ourselves. So yeah, as bad as this was, you probably thought it was a losing game. Really lucky catch at the end. So Yi is taking the inhibitor, no one's trying to answer that. Teemo set up his Zerat, so it's basically a free tower for us here. GP had to pull away, because if he didn't, I'd kill him. And if you have any doubts, here I go on Brand. Lux kills Brand. I just start wailing on GP, Ziggs gets in the way, so I start wailing on him. I kill GP, Lux will kill Ziggs, aced, their base is open, Yi is still alive to take what's left. So that's GG, game over. They're going to surrender, 4-1. Not entirely sure which one tried to hold out hope, but that was kind of it. So I wasn't really paying attention to the gold near the end, but we actually did take the lead backs. I can show you the graph when we actually did. So this will pull up the client. So the client there crashed, no surprise at this point, but yeah, there's just so many damn issues with it anyway. Bans were Yasuo, Cat, Camille, Zed, Blitz, Darius. You can see the various stats here. Yi was arguing, I'm not trolling, dude was 18-14, or 8-14, I mean. You can see in terms of gold, he actually did have the most because he never left the bot lane. It's just, he had no influence anywhere else. So overview is going to show us where the gold lead actually changed place. So this is when Lux killed Ziggs, Teemo killed Twitch and a tower. I killed a tower, and Yi killed GP. Prior to this, this is when I killed Twitch and GP. I don't remember which fight that was offhand. Well, I killed the bug, so I actually had a triple kill here. Actually, no, he respawned, apparently. But in the end, we had just, I think it was like 4,500 lead, yeah. And at their highest, they had about the same lead. Now, this is pretty surprising to me because of how strong Twitch is late game. I definitely wasn't expecting it to play out like that. In terms of champion gold, you can see me there on that curve, Lux, Teemo. I'm actually going to take Lux out since those share a color. Okay, those are pretty even. As for Yi, we snaked back and forth a couple times throughout there. Looks kind of like a malformed double helix there. You know what, I'll leave my stuff up. So, Ziggs, I was actually ahead of him the entire game. Twitch, he was just like Yi, he passed me a couple times, but still behind at the end. I figured GP would be ahead because his Q does give him free gold. And Teemo pretty much did give him a free lane for the most part. For Ka, I was ahead of him at all stages of the game. He never really caught up. And the support, that's to be expected. So out of curiosity. Yep. Moving on to the actual stats. First blood was performed on Yi, went to Brand. And I'll pull up the graphs. So there you go. For most damage dealt, that was me, the kind of tanky Xin Zhao with two damage items for most of the game and then the cleaver at the very end. Number two was Teemo due to Liandry's torment and nothing more. Three was somehow Yi. I thought Lux actually did more offhand, but number two for least, and she still did more than Ori. This is more of a testament to how useless Ori was throughout the game. She frequently missed her ults, and she was a shield bot, that's really all there was to it. For their team, Ziggs did the most. Part of this was due to him being able to harass from a distance. The other reason is whenever Twitch wanted to ult, I jumped on him. So basically he had to either choose to sit there and continue dealing damage knowing he was going to die within 2-3 hits, or try to bail. Number 3 was GP, and then you can see Kha'Zix did the least. So if nothing else, Ori can at least be proud she did more than the enemy jungler and the support. even though I almost did triple her damage. Then the other stat, damage taken. Once again, this goes to me. If Yi had meditate and actually used it properly, he should have been higher up, but he didn't. I'm able to be up here just due to that sheer amount of healing I had at times, so I could just sit in the fray and not die. I was kind of tempted to go for Guinso's Rage Blade, it's just I needed the mobility from the cleaver to actually stick to people once they started to run away. For them, their guy who took the most was Cossacks, followed by Twitch, the two guys I probably bullied more than anyone else throughout this game. And for the runes and masteries, this was the rune page. So scaling armor yellows, scaling MR blues, 1 crit red, 8 AD reds, and attack speed quints. For masteries, this was the page I used. So I was running Bounty Hunter, like I said, within 15 minutes I was at full damage. I'm running attack speed because I need to actually get the third proc in my W to stay healthy in the jungle. Now, Fresh Blood, I think I may have actually changed this page. I'm not sure if I went for Expose I might have actually stuck to that. My other option would be Expose Weakness in the hopes that my team actually did anything, which they kind of didn't. I went for this because I don't actually need the natural lifesteal. My W will keep me sustained, and actually getting some additional AD and AP off of this will give me more healing. Bounty Hunter, because I knew I was going to get kills. Armor penetration, even though I don't think they really had anything for, in terms of armor. Fervor of Battle for additional AD. Then I went for Savagery so I had a better clear, longer double buffs. Merciless so that I can try to kill people, and then 1 point in meditation so that I can keep my mana up. And of course Bandit, because you get additional gold. Unfortunately I didn't really look at the Bandit total at the end to see how much I actually got off of it, it's just... For as much as I jumped on people, it had to have been a pretty decent amount. But anyway, that was the agonizing Xin Zhao jungle game that we definitely should not have won because of how poorly three of the lanes were playing. Teemo, had he picked a direction and stuck to it, I think he would have been a much, much better asset than he actually was. But in the end, I have to say the second best player was easily the Lux. So yeah, sadly after that game I didn't really have much desire to play ever since. So next game will probably be coming up, I'll play on Wednesday for the next weekend's games. But that's it for now. I'm the Hero of Light, thanks for watching, and goodbye.